Welcome back to my kitchen for finally another episode of Whit's Kitch. I have the fabulous Amanda Ward in the kitchen.
Thank you.
Yes, she's actually a chef. Look, I'm like Vanna White. Yes, the fabulous.
Thank you.
First things first, we're cheersing. We're cheersing to this. We're toasting.
Toasting.
Cheers.
Like cheersing.
Yes, we are toasting because we have this fabulous food and fabulous friends in the kitchen.
You.
We're gonna have so much fun. Tell us what we're gonna do today.
I'm so excited to be here, and I'm so excited about this dish. We're gonna be having Mediterranean sea bass.
All right, so what do we start off with?
Yeah, okay, so what makes it Mediterranean is the topping. We're just gonna cook fish like you usually cook fish, and then we're gonna top it with this yummy combination of a tomato sauce with Kalamata olives, tomatoes, peppers, onions,
wait,
garlic.
What are these?
These are caper berries. I love caper berries. Then we're gonna top it with some Mediterranean herbed crumbled feta cheese.
Oh, yum.
Do you like cheese?
Girl, I'm like a rat. I've never met a cheese that I don't like. What do we have over here?
Over here are bell peppers. I use a red onion, lemon, garlic, and fresh basil.
And what is this?
This is some French salt.
Now that we have kind of the spread and we know what direction we're going, what do we do first?
Let's start chopping the vegetables first.
Okay.
So here's a great way to cut your bell peppers so that you don't have to pick the seeds off. You just go around the edge like this, and then you see this membrane here. You don't want to eat it.
Membrane.
Yeah.
It does kind of look like brains. So I'm not going to get those seeds, right?
Nope. Okay. So then the seeds and everything you don't eat.
So like this? I mean, just...
Yeah. A little further on the outside because the seeds are there.
Like
there
that?
We go.
Okay.
Perfect. You see where the seeds are now?
Oh,
so you
yeah. Yeah. So I could do that so I could see the seeds. Okay.
And then
that
it kind of cuts the membrane off too.
The membrane. We don't want the membrane. There. Did it.
Yes. Good job.
So you just do thin strips and it's about... a half inch wide.
This is called a flaming bell pepper.
I've never seen this color
before.
It's
both red and yellow. So I'm just gonna cut the onions too and leave them like halved.
But they're thin. This is,
right.
It's like a moon shape, but you still have them thin.
Yeah, so I'm using lots of garlic.
Do you remember garlic? Last time you asked me to get garlic and I got, what did you say, six what of garlic?
I said just six cloves.
Y'all,
cloves.
I came with six huge ones of these. She was like, what, how much did you get? And I said, you asked for six.
So funny. Do you want to mince this for me?
Yeah, I'd love to mince.
And I'm gonna start chopping these in half.
Now see, can I just do that?
Oh, that's so much better.
Okay, what do we do now?
I would like to get the fish out of the refrigerator and let's season it. The only thing we're gonna do here, we don't really have to score that much because we don't have that much bottom to score. Most of it's so thick. We wanna score it so that it doesn't curl. And you don't want to cut it too much, you just want to nick it. We want to put salt. Bam! Put a little wrist action in there. Yeah, it's as much as you want. You flavor it the way you like. And we're going to use some fresh basil in the end.
I love basil.
Can you turn on your oven? Medium-high heat. And then we will put a little grapeseed oil in. We want to coat that bottom really good. Let's turn on the pot for pasta too.
Oh,
put that
good.
On high.
Okay.
Now you have one of those big Morton salts.
Yes.
So
I'll be right
back. It's very important when you're making pasta to salt your water generously because that's about the only flavor you're going to add in your pasta. And if it's not salted while you're boiling it, it's going to be kind of bland.
All right.
Okay.
So we put the grapeseed oil in here. Mm-hmm. We started the boil for the pasta.
And let's turn it up a
you
little
wanna do
more.
It up a little bit?
Yep.
There we go.
And you can tell when it's ready because it just starts to shimmer. You can see the reflection. You need to put a little bit of oil in your pasta so that it doesn't stick, but you do not necessarily have to use olive oil because it's more expensive. You can use vegetable oil.
You know what? I'm going to go ahead and turn on the exhaust.
Sure.
It's going to be a little loud, but.
Yeah, we need the exhaust
totally.
Here.
Totally.
To get a crispy skin, right?
Yes.
You want a crispy skin.
Yes.
So you want it, place it in and just hold it down just a little bit. Don't lift it, but and don't shake it, and don't move it.
This is bubbling.
This is good. This is good. You want to make sure your fish is dry too. Okay. That's why I padded it with a.
It's not dry now. No, well, you mean putting it in there.
Before you put it in, you want it to be dry. You don't want it to be wet. I feel like I want to cover it because this fish is so thick.
You want to cover it? Okay.
Now, we just wait. 90% of the cooking time is going to be done on the skin side. It's going to stay in there a good 4 or 5 minutes. It will turn kind of opaque as it cooks. All right, so now, Whitney, it's time to flip the fish.
Oh my gosh, that looks so good.
Yeah, and look, it's so thick that we're going to turn it on 3 sides, okay? So fish is very delicate, and it crumbles easily, but this is such a chunk of fish, and I'm
impressed.
So it's nice and crispy, you see on the end? I'm going to flip it some more. Okay, now we're going to go on the 3rd side. Normally you only have to flip it once, but this fish is so chunky, we're going to have to triangulate it. What we're going to do is get prepared for when this is ready. We're going to slide it off onto a plate, and we're going to pop it into a warm oven. 250, the lowest. We just want it warm.
Okay.
And then we're going to pop it on a plate, skin side up.
Look, it kind of looks
beautiful.
Like fish
scales. It does. When you're cooking pasta, it's always good to follow the package directions on your thyme.
It says 11 to 13 minutes.
Perfect. Let's get that butter out. So I need a knife.
Oh, what kind of knife?
Just a butter knife.
Okay.
For the butter.
Okay.
Now, we want to take about 2 tablespoons and pop it in here. And Kerrygold butter is the best.
Kerrygold.
Kerrygold, Irish butter. You just want to baste this with the butter.
Like, I'm literally salivating right now.
Let's plate them each individually.
Let's do it.
Why
not? Okay.
Because it's so delicate, we don't want to transfer it twice.
No, we don't.
There we go.
Yay!
We have lots of oil and butter to work with here, which is perfect. And we're going to just saute.
Okay.
Vegetables. Let's put those fishies in the oven to keep them warm.
Okay.
What about that?
Hey, there we go. See, this smells so good.
It's smelling good.
Yes. And good things take time.
You always want to cook your peppers and onions for a little while longer before you add your garlic because you don't want to burn your garlic. Okay, now let's add the garlic. It's a good time. So you just want to scoop it up. These are petite diced tomatoes flavored with garlic and olive oil. Just pour that on in.
Oh, it smells good too. Mm-hmm.
So I like to take the basil leaves.
Yes.
Go down long ways and then chop it.
Mmm. Are we ready for
We're ready for the pasta.
Perfect. Everybody needs kitchen scissors.
This pita bread is from Sarah's Market. It's a Mediterranean market here in Dallas. They make this bread fresh daily.
I didn't know there was a Mediterranean market
there
here in Dallas.
There is, and you have to go. It's like a field trip. It's so amazing. Okay, so we also want to have some lemon for garnish. We're going to put it on the side of the plate, so if anyone wants any extra citrus.
I love citrus.
They can add their own. Knows it's going to be...
Woo!
Time for pasta. Look, Let's taste it. Okay, we're getting ready. We're getting so close.
This is hard work.
Let's plate one.
Okay. Oh, this smells so good. I'm gonna put a lemon on the side.
Yes. It's been reduced down to the right amount.
It's about to be really reduced.
I told you I said something.
Wait, what? Hold on. Wait, let me just put it back on.
On the wood?
Okay, wait.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, what do I do? Is it gonna ruin the wood?
No, it'll be fine.
It's okay, just a little bit, and we can put that in the compost.
There
is no wasted bell pepper. This happens all the time in my kitchen.
This is not lying.
I didn't even flinch. That looks so good. Amanda, you have been amazing in the kitchen.
There we go.
Still salivating. Here's a fork for you.
Thank you.
So we're gonna dig in.
Okay, try this fish. Is that the best fish ever?
It really is the best fish. Thank you guys so much for watching. Oh yes, my gosh, it was worth the mess. It was worth the splatter. It was worth everything. It's really the best ever. Do you want to come back?
Absolutely.
Okay,
please.
Y'all come back. We're going to have fun. You never know what's going to happen in my kitchen, but that's okay. That's what makes it fun. And we'll see you next time.
Mwah.
Bye. Let's go eat.
Okay, we're popping bottles. Ready? Yeah.
Get out of the way.
Oh, jeez. Oh, my God.
Grapeseed oil, and we're going to heat up this
pan. I am deathly allergic to grapeseed oil. No. Okay,
so Whitney, I was going to tell you. You want to put a little bit of oil.
I love the way that you just said my name to get my attention back on track. So, Whitney, I'm going to have to cut this over.
Get your kitchen scissors. Everyone needs kitchen scissors.
They sure do.
Where's your...